In this video, I'd like to take a look at test data. Once you've developed an algorithm, that could be a flowchart or pseudocode, it's important that we test that using a range of data. This includes ensuring that any validation you've created is also working as you expect. When testing, you're going to want to create a test plan, and that test plan shouldn't just include random values to test, it should include structured values, values that fulfill a certain criteria. So the exam boards are looking for some sort of logic, some sort of systematic pattern to your test data. They don't want to see you just pulling out random values from thin air as values that you're going to use to test your system. So what do I mean by this? Well, the data that you're going to use to test your systems should try to fall into these types, into these categories. You should be looking for some normal test data, some extreme data, some boundary data, and some abnormal or sometimes called erroneous data. So let's take a look at what I mean by normal test data first. So normal test data is typical data, expected data that we expect should be accepted by the system. So values that we expect to be accepted and are going to be okay. So in these examples, we're going to look at a system that's looking for integers between 1 and 5. So whole numbers between 1 and 5. You can see I've shaded in green the accepted range there. Numbers 1 to 5 are all perfectly fine numbers that should be accepted by the system. When it comes to picking some normal test data, I would just go straight down the middle. So in this example here, number 3 would be the value I would use as normal test data. The next category is something called extreme test data, data at the upper and lower limits of expectations that should also be accepted by the system. So with the same example, we've got a system here that's accepting integers between 1 and 5. The extreme values here, the values at the upper and lower limits of expectations, would be 1 and 5. So 1 and 5 would be the values I would test under the extreme test data category. The next type of test data is something called boundary test data. This is the pair of values at each end of the range. So the data at the upper and lower limits of expectations that should be accepted should be some of your values, and then the immediate values before or beyond these limits of expectations should be the other value, and these are values that should be rejected. So what do I mean by that? Well, in our example again, we're looking for numbers between 1 and 5. So 1 and 5 are at the extremes, are at the boundaries of what's acceptable, of what should be accepted. Then we go beyond those boundaries in both directions. So we're going to be testing 0 and 1, and we're going to be testing 5 and 6. We expect 1 to be accepted and 0 to be rejected, and we expect 5 to be accepted, and we expect number 6 to be rejected. So boundary data, the pair of values, testing the limits of what's accepted at both ends of the spectrum. And then we have abnormal test data, data that falls outside of what's acceptable and is rejected by the system. In our example here, numbers 1 to 5 we said was normal data that should be accepted, so anything outside of that is going to be abnormal data. But we want to be a bit clever here, we want to show the exam board that and we really do know what abnormal test data means. So yes, you could say number 6 is abnormal test data, and that's fine. But even better to say 6.5, because we're showing there that we know the value is outside of the range, it's beyond 5, and we're also saying that it's not a whole number, it's not an integer. 6.5 isn't a whole number. So again, we're showing that we really understand what abnormal test data means, that this should be rejected. You could take this principle even further again and say, what about entering words? Words should definitely be rejected. It's definitely erroneous. So for example, we could say 7.5 as a string, as text. And we're showing again there that words we expect to be rejected, and it's not a whole number either that we're expressing in words. So I would go with like 100, 7.5, anything like that is some really abnormal, terrible data that, of course, should be rejected by the system. So just to recap then, when it's time to test, your programs and your validation, when the exam board are asking you for typical test data that you may use to test a certain situation, don't just think, okay, let's make up some random values. The values that you suggest for testing should be values that fall under these categories, and you may be asked, why have you chosen those values? And the reason why you've chosen those values is because it fits these test criteria scenarios. So normal data, some everyday data that should be fine for the system, that should be accepted. In this other example here, in this final column, you can see if I'm accepting integers between 1 and 10, then I go with number 5. It's right in the middle. That's some nice normal data. I'd expect that to go through the system and have no issues whatsoever. The next category is extreme data. We said that was values of the upper and lower limits of what's okay, what's accepted. So if I'm accepting values between 1 and 10, I'd go with 1 and 10 as some extreme data, just to check that those values right at the edges of the acceptability are working fine and they're being accepted. Next category is boundary data. We're looking for power values at either end of the spectrum here. So I want to know, does my extreme data work? So in this example here between 1 and 10, is 1 working? But also if I go just further than that, I should be experiencing a rejection. So 1 and 0, and the other pair of values may be 10. And then if I go beyond 10 to 11, 11 should be rejected. How you write that down doesn't really matter so much, as long as you're clear about which values are going to be accepted, which one's rejected. And finally, abnormal data or erroneous data, just really ridiculous data that just falls way outside of what's normal, what should be accepted, and we're expecting these to be heavily rejected. So between 1 and 10, 13 is beyond 1 and 10, so 13 should be rejected. Even better, put it in words. Words, if I'm asking for a number value, should definitely be rejected, and so on.